And now on Sydney Weekend, Cheers with Ben Malouf. Thanks to firstvintage.com.au.
And Ben Malouf has joined us. Now, firstvintage.com.au is where you go to get all your wines. firstvintage.com.au. Benny, good afternoon.
Good afternoon and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Look, we spoke a while back about the difference between a $5 wine and a $25 wine. Was it really five times better? This time, I want to talk about sparkling wine. We're not allowed to say champagne because it's not champagne.
No, we've learnt a lot about like that, Dan.
Right? Because you can only say champagne if it's from that area of France.
Correct, and made in a very specific method.
There you go. Can you get a decent sparkling wine for under 20 bucks? Because a lot of them are pretty dear.
Yeah, look, absolutely. And you know what I always say? Buy Australian. There are some great Australian sparkling wines out there. I'm at the moment drinking something that's called Henry's Drive the Postmistress, and it's about $18, $19 a bottle, and it's beautiful. It's as good as any French bottle that I've been drinking over the last 4 or 5 years.
Henry's Drive the Postmistress. What?
Yeah, the Postmistress. It's a really cool winery down in Pathaway, down in South Australia, and it was on an old mail route, and they called this the Postmistress in honour of that.
Where do I get it?
Hey, we stock it on our website, firstvintage.com.au, so right. Go and check it out. But it's great for over the festive period, New Year's Eve and summer. I love bubbles coming into summer.
And should be served on ice?
Yeah, serve it nice and cold. You don't want to serve it icy cold. We've spoken about just letting the wine express those beautiful flavours. So serve it cold, but I personally don't serve anything icy cold.
And you don't have to buy Moët. Now, just on that, how do you pronounce it? Just let's settle it once and for all. Moët, Moët, what is it?
It's Moët and Moët. Chandon. Yes, so it's unlike you'd probably hear at a lot of barbecues around the country. It's not Maui, it's Moët. Yeah.
Okay, so you don't have to buy Moët?
No, absolutely not. Look, there's nothing wrong with French champagnes. I think why I love Australian wines and sparkling wines over, say, a French product is the French do things really, really well. But they do it in a very specific way, using a specific criteria, which means that you get great product, but you don't get the diversity. So if you're making wine in Australia, you're making sparkling wine in Australia, you're not you don't have those restrictions placed on you, and accordingly, you can make some really interesting, new and innovative products, and that's why I believe the Australian wine industry is the best, most innovative in the world.
There you go. Okay, so Moët. Say Moët so you don't sound like a dill. We see from time to time blends. We hear people say, oh, I don't drink blends. What are they? What's a blend? And should we steer clear of them? And if so, why?
No, you shouldn't steer clear of blends. I love blends. So when you walk into a bottle shop and you see a Sauvignon Blanc, that is a grape variety and a wine style. So Sauvignon Blanc or Riesling or Semillon, any of those things. A blend is just bringing together two of those grape varieties and wine styles. So some common ones that you'd probably see out in the marketplace would be Semsav Blanc, which is a blend of Semillon and Sauvignon Blanc. And you can always tell which wine variety has more of it in a bottle because it is the first one on that actual bottle. So if you see Semillon Sauvignon Blanc, there's more Semillon. If you see Sauvignon Blanc Semillon, then there's more Sauvignon Blanc.
Right, and did they just combine the grape mix? So, you know, they get the wine from that grape.
Yes.
That harvest, combine it with the other one, bung them in together, and away you go.
Pretty much, and you're trying to come up with a unique, different, interesting sort of flavour.
Enid wants to talk to you, Ben. Enid, good afternoon.
Hello. I was just hearing the discussion about the champagne, Moët and Chandon. We've been to the vineyard, and we asked them how to pronounce it, and they told us it was wet.
Oh, not another one, Enid.
That's from the vineyard themselves.
From the horse's mouth. Just to confuse things a little further. And so the debate will rage on.
It will. But I think we're right because we came from the horse's mouth.
Mouet.
Mouet. Like wet with an M before it.
Mouet. Mouet and Chandon.
Chandon. E-T.
Mouet et Chandon.
Oui.
Oh. Enid.
We'll take that on good authority. Thanks for that.
Okay. You've totally confused us. There you go. Mouet. Ben, Kim has called in. G'day, Kim.
G'day. How are you?
We're both well. Go ahead.
Look, I've got a Moët Chandon 1971.
Wow. That would be quite a drop, I would imagine. Have you considered popping it open and giving it a go?
Well, Well, no, we haven't. We got it for our wedding anniversary, our wedding, I should say, and it was given to us by a very close friend, Neil Beachley, which is Lane Beachley's father.
Oh, fantastic. So how long have you had it? Year did you... Was it vintage when you were given it, is what I'm trying to work
83,
out?
83.
So it was already 12 years old then?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
But, Ben...
The cork hasn't swollen. It's still fine. There's no busting on it. But I don't know how it's going to actually perform.
Well, that's my question, Kim, to Ben. For sparkling wines, do they have an optimum period? Is it going to keep getting better the longer Kim keeps it in the cellar? Or should he say, or is there a sort of a yardstick where they say, well, sparkling wines of that nature, he should really pop it and drink it?
Look, if it's been stored correctly, that wine will be absolutely spectacular. And funnily enough, Verclico actually found a sunken ship from 150 years ago, I think it was last year, and they found some Veuve Clicquot at the bottom of the ocean, cracked it open, and it was in impeccable. It held up perfectly.
Look, we're running out of time, unfortunately. We're going to have to leave it there, Benny. But look, firstvintage.com.au, firstvintage.com.au. Those other two questions there are really important, and I want to get them. We'll do them next week, all right?
Done. Looking forward to it, Dan.
Because someone emailed me this week and wanted you to settle a bet. She said that altar wine served at church is claret.
Watch this space.
Ben Malouf, you'll find him at firstvintage.com.au. It's where you get the best wines in the country.